हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू मरीन इंजीनियरिंग हब। दिस इज नरेटर रवि गुप्ता। टुडे आई एम गोना टॉक अबाउट सोलेनोइड वाल्व। दिस इज द सोलेनोइड वाल्व। इन टुडे टॉपिक आई विल कवर हाउ द सोलेनोइड वाल्व इज एक्टिवेटेड एंड व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन द सोलेनोइड वाल्व इज एक्टिवेटेड एंड हाउ इट इज बीन कंट्रोल्ड। सो फर्स्ट लेट अस सी वेयर द solenoid valve is placed. The solenoid valve is placed in between the thermostatic expansion valve and a condenser. And if you want to be precise, you can say the solenoid valve is provided in between the filter dryer and a thermostatic expansion valve. Okay. So how the solenoid valve is activated? Solenoid valve is activated thermostatic on and off by monitoring the room temperature of a evaporator. So what do I mean by that? The thermostatic expansion valve allow the flow of a high pressurized refrigerant to the thermostatic expansion valve by a thermostatic switch. This thermostatic switch will give us the electrical signal to the solenoid valve, and through that it will be activated and it will allow the refrigerant to flow. This electrical switch will be activated by the sensing valve provided inside the evaporator. That evaporator will, when the temperature of the evaporator increases, at that time the sensing valve will sense and will give the signal to thermostatic switch and it will activate the solenoid valve. So let's see what I've written here. The sensing valve fluid expand as the temperature of the evaporator increase, which push the bellow, causing the thermostatic switch on position. So what do I mean by that? When the temperature of the evaporator increases, at that time the sensing valve liquid will turn into gaseous form and will exert a pressure on this bellow. As the pressure will be exerted on this bellow, this thermostatic switch will be activated to the on position. As it will be in the on position, the solenoid valve will be energized and it will allow the flow of refrigerant to the thermostatic expansion valve. As the thermostatic switch is on, it is energized the solenoid valve, causing the refrigerant to flow to a thermostatic expansion valve, as I have showed you. What happened when the solenoid valve is activated? Okay, so now first before that, we'll see the solenoid valve. As you can see, this is the refrigerant, high pressure refrigerant coming from the condenser, and this is when this solenoid valve, this T-piece is lifted up, the refrigerant will flow from here to the thermostatic expansion valve. Now, this is the solenoid valve. This is the solenoid coil. Means this is basically, what do I mean by solenoid coil is the electromagnetic coils. Okay. This is the basically solenoid coils. And this is the sleeve. And this is the T-piece. And this is the valve. The T-piece is been on the other end connected to a valve. So let's see. As the solenoid coil get energized, it pull up the sleeve, causing the sleeve to move up in the upward direction, which will hit the valve spindle T-piece and tap the valve in the open position. So as the solenoid valve is getting energized thermostatically, it will create a magnetic effect here. As the magnetic effect will be created, this sleeve will be attracted, as because a magnetic field will be generated here, this will be attracted in the upward direction. As it move in upward direction, it will hit this T-piece, and as it will hit this T-piece, the valve on the other end will move in the upward direction. As the valve will move up, this will open the opening for the liquid refrigerant from the high pressure condenser to flow to the thermostatic expansion valve. Now, when the solenoid coil get de-energized, this slip piece will move down, and because of its weight, it will hit this part of the T-piece, and it will move the valve in the downward direction, causing the valve to close. As it will close, it will shut down the flow of a refrigerant from the condenser to the thermostatic expansion valve. So, as the solenoid coil get de-energized, the sleeve fall in the downward direction and close the valve in the set position. So, basically, what do I want to know? Say you that you should know that the solenoid valve is thermostatically activated by a thermostatic switch, and as it is activated, it will allow the mass flow of refrigerant in a bulk quantity to a thermostatic expansion valve, and the amount of refrigerant to be flown to a evaporator is controlled by a thermostatic expansion valve. Solenoid valve function is to allow the mass flow once in a time. Okay, so I hope you understand how a solenoid valve is working in a refrigeration system. If you have any doubt, please do comment in the comment box. I will give up the answer. If you like the video, please do subscribe and please hit the bell icon, and please do share this video on your Facebook and your WhatsApp classes. Please remain in home, please be safe, and have a good day. Image credit goes to Mac George.